video is to introduce you to the MDX-700HD tester from Midtronics. The tester is designed for commercial vehicles particularly. When a technician approaches a vehicle, if they access the batteries, you're going to connect the negative battery test clamp to the negative cable that's the primary ground, and the positive cable that's going directly to the starter. Once the tester's connected, the screen will automatically come on and you can enter the vehicle. From the driver's seat, you'll be ready to test. We are in vehicle testing. You can test individual batteries out of the vehicle as well. But in this case, we're in the vehicle and they are top post batteries. These are standard Group 31 truck batteries. So we'll select that from the menu option. You'll note that there are several options available. It's a general purpose tool, but it's tailored specifically for heavy duty vehicles with up to 6 batteries. In this case, we're selecting 4 batteries and they are 12 volt batteries. They are regular flooded batteries. There are different algorithms as well for the AGM flat plate and AGM spiral. They have slightly different characteristics, so we have to adjust for those properly. By pressing enter, we're going to select the battery rating type, and it is CCAs. There are multiple ratings available, of course, but the standard that we typically see in the trucking industry is a cold cranking amp rating. All the standard battery ratings that are used in the automotive industry today are also represented in this tool. The batteries in this vehicle are rated in CCAs at 700 CCAs, so we'll select that. When you select test, the battery pack test results will be displayed. Good pack, we've got the measured voltage and the rated CCA. There are several pack test results that may come up. We've got a good battery test. Now we're going to simply press enter, and the prompt is to start the engine. Ideally, you'll have all the stable vehicle loads turned off at this time prior to the start. When you have the green light to start, crank the engine. When you crank, you're going to get a display where it says the result is starting system normal. It also displays the measured voltage at the time of crank and the time it took to crank. There could be some other results that would come up during this portion of the test, and cranking skipped could be the result if you happen to have an air starter in the vehicle. For the charging system test, we're going to go ahead and simply hit enter. It's looking for DC voltage, looking for alternator output. It's going to prompt you to rev the engine. We're looking for the measured DC voltage and AC voltage. When you go back down to idle with the loads off, taking one more analysis. Now it's asking you to turn on all the stable vehicle loads. Don't turn on the windshield wipers because that could scuff the windshield, and it's an impulse type load. Stable loads only. Now we're going to rev the engine again, 1500 to 2000 RPM. It's capturing the information and revs were detected. So now you go back to engine idle, hit enter, and it's safe to start turning all the loads off. The actual test is completed at this point in time. Now by hitting enter once again, you can review all the test information. No problems were found and the voltage was the same, whether loaded or non-loaded. There are some outputs that might be identified if there were a problem with the alternator output. We can print out that information and provide a written copy, either for the customer or for our own records to keep track of with this particular vehicle. The results are indicated from top to bottom. Battery test is good. Cranking is normal. Charging system shows no problems. This can be utilized as a PDI tool, as a simple service tool, or doing more direct service operations. When the test is completed, the vehicle is safe to go back out on the road.